I'm honestly not here to really talk about the pricing of Blue Apron stock. That's really up to the investors to decide. You know, Blue Apron is here because we're excited about the big opportunity that we're going after. We're tackling a huge market, and we're focused on the long term, quite frankly. And the stock price today, whether it's up, down, left, or right, is really just the beginning of this new chapter in our company's life that we're really excited about.
So no sense of urgency? You didn't want to see this happen sooner rather than later?
You know, going public, this wasn't a special moment that we needed to go public right now. You know, since the beginning of when we incorporated the company, the very first day, we wanted to build the kind of company that could be a public company, the kind of caliber of company that's going after a big enough opportunity with a long enough orientation and an ambitious enough business plan. And so that's really been the strategy since the very earliest days.
As you've gone through this process of kind of telling investors your story, trying to get them interested and involved for the long term, I mean, what have you had to persuade them of? What have you had to keep emphasizing? How can you tell them that the business model that you've got right now is going to work?
Well, look, it's the performance. I mean, we've grown our business 10 times over the last 2 years, so demand for what we do has been incredible. You know, we have really powerful unit economics in terms of the amount of revenue we generate per customer, and we have incredible engagement around what we do. You know, we're doing things in the food business in terms of creating economic value to deliver to our customers through an integrated end-to-end supply chain that is differentiated and allows us to engage customers in a way that is really exciting.
You talk about those unit economics, but something else you also have is fairly high churn. At least that was a concern of a number of the investors who I spoke to who looked at the IPO. It costs a lot to get a customer. I was one of them, by the way. I enjoyed the service, but after a few months, we stopped using it in my home for a variety of reasons, and I would imagine those reasons may apply to any number of other people. Aren't you just on a spinning wheel where you may not necessarily get the kind of growth you're talking about in terms of the bottom line because of the problems I'm talking about?
No, actually, I mean, the unit economics for what we do are really incredible and very strong.
Well, so, give them to us. Then.
Yeah, so over a historical period, on a three-year period, we generate between $900 and $1,000 for the average customer over 3 years, compared to a very reasonable customer acquisition cost, which if you look at historically, based on what we disclosed in our S1 and elsewhere, we return in under 6 months on our marketing spend on average for every customer we acquire. And one of the big opportunities for Blue Apron, quite frankly, going forward, is to even grow that revenue generation per customer by going into new categories so we can sell more products to the same customers we've already acquired and deliver and develop new products for some of the customers today that we don't currently serve. And part of the reason over the last 5 years that we haven't served everyone is we've focused on scale. You know, and that was absolutely the right decision for us at that time. But at this point, you know, as we continue to see opportunities to scale, we're being more thoughtful about designing new products for new segments of the market that historically we've told people that we just don't have a product for you yet.
New products within grocery. Or
so,
beyond.
Yeah, broadly. So if you think about on recipes, you know, there's opportunities in new day parts for us, opportunities with different dietary preferences that we don't serve today, different price points for customers, different cadences, different, cooking occasions. And so there's a lot there as well. And we also have businesses in wine. We're a vertically integrated direct-to-consumer winery where we sell things like white Burgundy and Napa Valley Cabernet Sauvignon for $10 a bottle.
We have some upstairs.
It is incredible wines at incredible values paired with our meals. And we also have a cooking supplies business. So there's a lot of opportunity to do more with the brand that we've built that customers love and care about and the platform we've created from a agricultural perspective, from a food manufacturing and national distribution perspective. So
hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.